Hi, AT from CNC at Home. We've had some work done on our house, and I wanted to give the contractor a quick little present. He's done a pretty good job. He recently has purchased part of the company, and I want to encourage him in that. To do that, I'm going to make him a couple coasters. Let's start by bringing in the template for that. So we'll just open up. We'll grab the 108 millimeter template. All that is a square down here that's 108 millimeters. I'm going to click here to zoom in on that area. The next step is to bring in the logo for the company. To do that, I just do File, click on Import, and then I'll select the image. With this image in place, we can see that it's a little bit small. So I'm going to make sure that I'm anchored around the middle. I'm going to lock the aspect ratio so that it keeps that consistent. And I'm just going to make it bigger until it looks about the right size. That seems good. The image seemed to come in right in the center, but let's make sure. I select the image, and then by holding the Shift key, I'm going to select our tile template, and then I'm just going to quick do an alignment. Nothing moved, so everything's good. For the settings, I'm going to go under Tile. This is going to be a titanium dioxide, and this is an image, so I'm going to assign that to my layer. So this is set correctly. We can take a quick peek at it. We've got 4,000 millimeters per minute, 75% power. We can use Jarvis dithering single pass. That all looks good. This is all set. The next thing we do is send this to the laser, see how that comes out. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Let's head over to the laser and see how it burns. I have a tile in place. I've already focused the laser. Let's do a quick frame, and if that's framed up correctly, we'll start the burn. That turned out pretty well. Take this over to the sink, get the titanium dioxide cleaned off. We'll take a look at it. Should be pretty good. I usually skip filming this particular step. I thought I would do it with this titanium oxide so you can see how easy the cleanup is. Just have some running water, get it wet, and just light brush with my hand, it just comes right off. Now it does usually slop over onto the edge a little bit, so I'll get that cleaned up. I can feel the tile is nice and smooth. Just run my thumb over here, just make sure I got it all cleaned up. That's all there is to it. I do have some titanium dioxide on my hands now, so I'm just going to use some soap and water because this will clean right off. As we found in my safety video, we know that the titanium dioxide is pretty safe for humans. It's non-carcinogenic, and it cleans up pretty well just with regular water. So I could leave it on there, but why bother? I made it at the sink. Go ahead and get it washed off. Well, actually, I'll take this towel. Let's get this dried up as well. Now the backside of the tiles has gotten wet in the washing process. So I'm gonna go set these out in the sun, as I've done two of these, and that'll get that last little bit dried up nicely.
These turned out really well. I did use a thinner mixture of the titanium dioxide, so more denatured alcohol, a little less of the titanium. I did put cork backings on each of these with the CNC logo, got that burned on there. They turned out really well. I hope they like them.
Let's get this under the microscope and take a closer look at how this burn turned out. This titanium dioxide seems to burn so nicely compared to the other methods. Just zoomed in closely. Take a look at the R. We'll zoom in on that gray area. Again, look at the accuracy and the clarity. I'm definitely going to be switching to this method going forward.
If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up. As always, if you enjoy the content of our channel, think about subscribing. That really helps us out. Enjoy doing your CNC at home projects.